All right, YouTube. So a little bit different send-off today. It is Thursday. It's 12 o'clock, right at noon. The conditions here in Thai are a little smoky. Still got ash falling out of the sky and still got fire happening. But it looks like most of the main town protection is pretty well taken care of. So you know what that means. We're going racing. Heading to PIR. Got everything loaded up. Got the YZ all cleaned up, loaded up. Just got the box from Bulletproof Designs. So we got the radiator guards and all the other goodies in there. Taking it with me. Maybe we'll get time to put it on the bike. We'll see. I've never been there before, so I don't know how hectic and fast paced everything gets once we get to the track. But everything's cleaned up, shined up, loaded up. Got all my gear, my boots, my helmet, yada yada. So we're gonna head on down and get in line or get prepared to be let in. I don't know exactly how it works. I think they open up the access to the track at 3:30 or something like that, 3:45. So leaving at noon is going to be plenty of time and everything. But being my first time there, I don't want to be late and in a rush and hurried or none of that. So whoop whoop, let's get out of this smoke and see if we can get some better breathing, huh? We're at the back of the line. We're like at the road. So tons of people here early today. Beautiful. It's only like 80 something degrees. 81, 82. Let's see if I can get there. 83 is what it's saying now. So beautiful weather. Feeling great. So should be awesome. They let us in. Woo! We got our spot, got some trees, some shade. See the lights from the track over yonder. We'll go check it out and explore in a bit. trigger. Dang. All right, so. Oh boy, that was something else. I suck. Hope you guys can see something and the roof wasn't too bad.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there we go, boys. Second moto. I think I got lapped by more people that moto than the first one. No time to clean the screen. I hope it was clean. Yeehaw! All right, guys, after race video, just like normal. So I only raced one class. That was the over the hill 40 plus novice. They didn't have beginner for the old guys, just beginner. So I went ahead and raced that. Raced both rounds of it, or both heat motos. There we go, both motos of it. I got last place, both moto. Super slow like I always am, but I expect to be slow because I am slow. not good at being a moto guy. I felt like I was, especially on the second heat, I felt like I was charging a little harder and pushing the bike harder, clutching it more, trying to keep it up in the revs better. But just walked away. I mean, everyone else just walked away. Looking around, it looks like almost everybody in my class was on 450. So a little 125, you know, not an excuse. But a great rider could ride that 125 and be up there in the top or winning, no problem. So it's not the bike's fault. It's definitely the rider, but definitely underpowered and hard to try and ride as good as I need to on a track that I just learned. And I didn't clear any jumps. I didn't feel comfortable on a lot of them. There's a rhythm section on the back side of the track, and you'll see it, I'm sure, in either the practice or one of the first heat race. I landed that all wrong and about got bounced and seat ejected off the bike. So I was really hesitant the second moto to try and jump anything or clear anything on that stuff. I was just trying to stay as low to the ground as I could and just charge through it all and not catch any air on any of it, which probably made me slower, but that's just what it is. Didn't want to get bucked like I did that first time. The sun, the second heat, I was really fearing the sun was going to be right in my eyes, really hard to see. It actually went down enough by the time my heat came that it's already down enough, so it wasn't super blinding. Yes, there was a little bit of sun, but nothing too terrible. Super fun experience. The soil here at PIR has got a lot of sawdust in it, sand and dirt. And it's very, like when we walked on it, did the track walk before practice and everything, it felt very muddy and soft and squishy. And I thought, oh no, this is gonna be terrible. You know, most of the time you walk on stuff like that where you're slipping, trying to go up the little hills and stuff, it's just terrible. It's just super muddy and nasty. Well, this place didn't. It packed down during practice, and especially like the starting line, and you'll see it in the video, the roost flies like crazy. But even the 125 pulled the front wheel up. Like, there's so much traction that it's just really incredible. I don't think there's as much turning traction. Like, I felt my front end sliding a lot on it. But as far as front bite with the rear tire and get traction, tons of bite. So, very good soil. You know, the track layout was good. The jumps and stuff were not peaky and edged and really bucked you at all. They were all nice rounded. So if you hit them with speed, it would pop you up. But if you didn't hit them with speed, you could just roll over them, no problem. A couple people had said that they were going to be super peaky and hard to jump. Not at all. Not on this day. It was actually very nice, very easy to, for a guy like me, an amateur, very new to riding moto, to go out and ride a track and not feel like, holy crap, off every jump, you know. When they're peaky, when they're sharp edge on the top of them and it just pops your bike, whether you want to or not, that's hard to ride. So. Had a great time. It was super fun. Hope you guys enjoyed the videos and stuff. Moto is a little weirder to do than off-road racing because, you know, two motos with three laps and a practice of three laps. You know, I don't know what the total amount of recorded time of actually racing or riding the bike's going to be, but it's going to be super small, like 15-minute video. And I'm just not used to that. I'm used to having, you know, 2 hours of video footage. To edit down or to do whatever I want with. So it's gonna be a little different with this one. Be a short video, which you guys will probably love, because that's all what YouTube wants, right? Short videos, 6-minute edits, done and out. I'm glad to not do what YouTube wants. Hope you guys like the vid. We'll be doing some more fun stuff, trying to plan out some more fun stuff that we haven't done before, go to some other tracks like this that we haven't been to before, and get some, you know, unique footage for the channel, not just hitting the same stuff up over and over again, and try and get some fresh stuff going. So I hope you guys enjoy, and hope you guys come back. All right, see you later.